Good morning, dear students. Here today I will introduce you about future tense. Dear students, you might have studied in my previous videos present tense, past tense. What we are talking about, the present time situation. Okay, that time you are using the present tense. You know very well, simple present tense, continuous present tense, perfect present tense, perfect continuous present tense. Already I have explained you in a previous video. Now, then after I explain you about past tense. Now today I will introduce you future tense. When we are talking about the past events, we use past tense. But when we are talking about coming time, okay, so in this case, we use future tense. Now, future tense, in this tense, we are using, suppose what we are using in present tense, we are using happy verb. Is, am, are, for showing the continuous present tense. Okay, in past tense also we are using was, were, did, that we are using. Here we have two verb of be. They are shall and will. This we are using in as a helping verb to make future tense. Dear students, why we are using this both the word, you must be concentrate about shall and will. Most probably we use I and we. Shall we use with the I. Okay? And we see it, they, we are using will. But nowadays, you can use will with these two also. It is going on. Okay? But it looks good if you write with I and we with the shall. Okay? It creates your impression. Now, dear students, we will talk about the simple future tense. In simple future tense, we have subject, will or shall, will one means base form. And object. When we are talking about future event, future matter, we use simple future tense. In simple future tense, we have fixed structure. This is subject, you can use will or shall, you can use V1 base form and object. Okay, you can write in this way. We shall play tennis tomorrow. We shall play tennis tomorrow. Means today we are playing something new and tomorrow we will play tennis. It is a quite fixed. Okay. We use the word tomorrow, the next day, next year, next month. Okay, after some days, this type of words we are using in for showing the future tense. When you are making it negative, simply you will have to put here not. We shall not play tennis tomorrow. We shall play another game. This way you can make it negative by putting the word not. Similarly, you can make question by using shall in the beginning. Shall we play tennis tomorrow? Then you can make, you can turn the sentence into the interrogative sentence. Shall we play tennis tomorrow? This is make the interrogative sentence for the simple future tense. So, dear students, here We are talking about the simple future tense. One more thing I will add here for your understanding, the use of going to. Dear students, we use this word also to show the simple future. We can show the future tense by this word suffer. But this word, when you use this word, you must have structure, subject, plus, is, am, are, plus going to, plus V1 means base form. Okay, plus object. So you can use this going to word in this sentence also. You can write in this way, we are, according to the subject we use, form of to be. We are going to play tennis. We are going to play tennis tomorrow. So in present tense, simple, in future tense, we are using in place of shall or will. You can use is, am, are plus going to. This is also one of the structure in your future tense. You can write in this way.
By car to our home.
while putting the auxiliary verb on the place of beginning. Will later be coming by train tomorrow? So this way, dear students, you can make the sentence in future continuous tense. No doubt I will share you exercises and the things which is necessary for you. One more example I will give you.
Future perfect tense with the
formation. Dear students, this is the way. This is the way you can introduce your future tense. Okay? So dear students, almost I have explained you in one by one video, present tense, past tense and future tense. I hope that you revise it again and again and learn and understand everything. Do all the exercises. So by next topics, whatever the passive voice and indirect speech will be coming, that time it is very helpful to you. Okay? Thank you. Have a good day.